Day two of the Sepang test saw some scorching lap times set under the sun, with 2023 Malaysian GP race winner Enea Bastianini top of the pile. The Ducati Lenovo team rider posted a stunning 157.134 towards the end of the day, 0.3 quicker than Pecco Bagnaia's all-time lap record and over 0.1 quicker than Jorge Martin on the day. With three of their machines inside the top four, the Ducati brand continued a busy couple of days of testing. The Bologna Bullets brought a slightly different exhaust into the fold on Wednesday, while both Bagnaia and Bastianini were spotted trying out the new aero that Michele Pirro had been running with. Across the independent teams, we didn't see too many innovations, but Gresini's Alex Marquez put in a very quick Tissot sprint simulation, with 7 of his 10 laps quicker than what we saw here when he won the 2023 Malaysian GP sprint. While on the other side of the Gresini box, Marc Marquez also put in a very impressive sprint simulation aboard his Ducati machine. There are encouraging signs at Honda, as it seems they have taken a step forward. Joan Mir is the best place of the RC213Vs in P10, but his 157.872 is almost 0.6 faster than his qualifying lap time at Sepang in 2023. Further encouragement can be found too from Luca Marini's sprint simulation, with the Italian posting consistent high 159s over 13 laps. For reference, during the 2023 Malaysian sprint, of all four Hondas on track, they managed to just get two 159 laps, while Taka Nakagami also showed a significantly better pace in his simulation. In terms of testing, Mir and Marini did most of their running with the new Honda swing arm, seemingly preferring it over the Kalex version, while it seems all four riders were on a similar testing plan throughout the day. Aprilia had a productive day as well, despite the enforced absence of Raul Fernandez, as they tested some new swing arms, while Aleix Espargaró had a new rear wing on top of his tail unit. Perhaps most strikingly, we saw Espargaró, Maverick Viñales and Miguel Oliveira go out together under the baking Malaysian sun as they attempt to find a solution to some of their struggles in the heat, which we saw last season. Viñales also produced the most laps of any rider throughout the day with 62, though he did suffer a crash. Over at KTM, Brad Binder got himself into the top 3 times of the day with a time that is under the official lap record, while the South African was also seen riding with a new exhaust setup similar to Jack Miller's on Tuesday. Both factory riders also tested the new aero on their RC16s, while at Gas Gas, Pedro Acosta took P8 on the timesheets, with a lap that would have been good enough to put him P5 on the grid in 2023, though a turn 9 crash is a blot on the copybook. Yamaha's Fabio Quartararo and Alex Rins look to have found a preferred aero setup, as both riders are running the M1 without the side pods, though it seems they still need to make a decision on their tail unit, with test rider Cal Crutchlow running the older unit on both of his bikes throughout the day. 2021 world champion Quartararo was the best place Yamaha on Wednesday, though he finished just outside the top 10 in P11. That's it from day two of the official Sepang test. One more day to go, and you can stay up to date with all the action on MotoGP.com.